I've been looking forward to this. Jason Segel spent 9 seasons, of course, in the hit sitcom, Love, Marshall, brought the Muppets to life for a whole new generation, gave us one of the most cringeworthy yet hilarious breakup scenes in movie history. Am I right? In Sex Tape, he and Cameron Diaz play a couple trying to rekindle the romance by scheduling some, let's say, alone time.
Maybe Thursday.
Fantastic, because it feels like it's been a long time.
It has, right?
Yeah. Last time was when we got those towels from Bed Bath & Beyond.
Oh, that's right.
We had a linen sale.
Look, we can't talk about this right now because we both
not the right time. Gotta get going.
It's just been so hard to find the moment with the kids. At the end of the day, we're just both so exhausted, you know?
Oh, just tell me about it. Maybe one of these nights we'll have sex instead of watching Project Runway. We'll TiVo Project Runway.
That's probably why they invented TiVo, so people could have sex.
Oh, we are happy to have Jason with us this morning.
Thank you.
One of our stage managers, Eddie Luisi, is laughing along.
Yeah.
And I have a feeling, Jason, first of all, welcome.
Thank you. Glad to have you here. I'm excited to be here. Thank you.
A lot of people are, it's a great date flick.
Yeah.
And they're going to be back in the car just nodding along going, yeah.
That's the hope. I think that on the ride back from seeing the movie, you'll talk about how funny it was in this moment or that moment. And then there'll be that awkward pause. And then a couple will look at each other and the real conversation will start. That I think it's really easy to slip into a routine after so many years of being together of not putting your intimacy at the forefront of the relationship. So hopefully it'll spur some conversation.
I'm sure that it will. And I love how you've said, as a great screenwriter, that you life experiences, that you just kind of put that up on the screen for us all.
Yeah, well, I think for me, what's always funny is when I see something on screen that makes me feel like, oh my gosh, that's me. And then that person has the most humiliating experience they could possibly imagine. That, to me, is hilarious.
You can't wait for this for it to end so you can write it down.
Yeah, totally.
And make sure that you get it on
there.
There is so much more to this. I really enjoyed watching it.
Thank you.
Yes, okay, Sex Tape. And yes, it is hilarious, that portion of
it.
But it's just like a mad caper in some kind of ways in that you're trying to retrieve the video or the tape on the iPads.
I grew up loving movies like Romancing the Stone and Adventures in Babysitting. Yeah. So it's a story about a couple trying to reclaim what was theirs, like their love life, over one night. And it really is like a nonstop sort of madcap adventure where a couple re-falls in love.
Rob Lowe, oh my goodness, he was...
Yeah, he's a killer, man. he's just the best.
He did. But I have to say, you and Cameron, she was here yesterday, and she could not say enough great things about you. But there's this comfort level, and you both approach comedy the same way. All in.
Yeah. She's very physically attractive. I was very lucky in the making of this movie. You become a writer for a reason, and this movie is it. And then, you know, you get to set, and honestly, it felt like a game of comedy chicken, and neither of us were turning the wheel. She's just so, she's so game, and they use the expression, just one of the guys, but I think it does a disservice to women. She's a woman standing on her own 2 feet going at comedy as hard as I've ever seen anything. So it was an honor to be a part of.
Well, you both hold your own on the screen, and you talked about how attractive she is. You're getting some raves, too. In fact, we heard a lot because you look fantastic, and
you even talked
to Jimmy Kimmel about it, and we have a question on posted on Facebook.
Yes.
How much weight have you lost? Was that for the movie? You talked to Kimmel about this.
Yes. I don't get on a scale. I judge by the mirror. But I lost exactly 35 pounds.
The mirror told you that?
Yeah, something like that.
But you said knowing that you were going to be up there with Cameron.
Yeah, well, the movie needed to be, in my opinion, really laser focused. That it's a couple who is not sleeping together because of time and the realities of life and children. And I didn't want people to be able to look at the poster or the movie and say, I think that they're not sleeping together because he's super fat.
You've taken that out of the equation.
Yes.
We would have thought that at all.
Thank you.
Also, you're going to be an author. Nightmares.
Yeah.
What's that?
It's a young adult, like Harry Potter age, trilogy of novels. It's the first thing that I ever wrote when I was like 22 years old. And after working on Muppets and being around children and seeing the way the imagination of a child works, I just figured it would be neat to put something in print where a kid got to make whatever they wanted of it. Like every individual kid gets to have their own experience with a book. And that felt like a special thing to
me. When is that coming out?
It comes out September 9th.
Oh, we'd love to have the back to talk about that.
Yeah, I would love it. I think you'll enjoy it.
Yeah, I'm sure. You're such a Renaissance man.
Oh, thanks. I'm just not afraid of being terrible at stuff. That's all.
And that never happens, Jason. Thanks very much. Sex Tape hits theaters nationwide on Friday.